I believe, now more than ever, that life is a journey. My life is one journey among billions. It's a journey of thoughts, emotions, and decisions that I make as I strive to do my best, to be my best. Most of the times, I make the usual decisions, feel the usual things, think the way that I usually do. People don't change easily, and sure enough, I'm not much of an exception. Still, I look back at how far I've come on this journey, and it surprises me just how much change I've undergone. Each passing second is a brand new second. Time passes, and though I don't feel it, I am evolving. I am changing. I have to wonder, 5 years from now, how much will I change? 10 years from now, how different of a person will I be compared to who I am now? I can't answer those questions right now, but what I can do is look back. Back at the things I used to do, things I used to believe in. If there was such a thing as a time machine and allowed younger versions of me to meet me as I am now, what would they think? What would those younger versions of me think? What questions would they ask myself? That sounds like a really good thought experiment. All right, let's try it out. Let's meet the younger versions of me, going from the oldest to youngest. You still haven't started graduate school? Dude, it's been such a long time coming. I really can't believe it's taken this long. Can you really hold out until mid-August to finally be able to start? And how did you not get into the advanced standing one-year program? Are you upset you have to, you know, do college work for 2 more years? You have a pretty ridiculous student loan debt already. It's, you know, you started out with $100,000 in student loan debt. So how are you going to afford graduate school? And lastly, what is that you're wearing over your shoulder there? You've been wearing backpacks pretty much all your life, and you now decide to go with satchels? Didn't you once consider them to be ugly man purses? I mean, how did you end up adopting those over the traditional backpacks, which I still love to wear all the time? Seriously? Oh, I'm gonna be fired from this shelter that I'm working at, but damn it, I love this job. I was planning to stay working here for years, man. For what stupid reason do I screw this up? Do I mess up badly? Does that ruin my, you know, pretty much social work career and goals? Why did you do that? You don't own a gun, right? Okay, good, so you don't own a gun. I mean, I can't imagine me or you ever being able to use a gun and hurting someone or some animal for, you know, for whatever sake. I'm too squeamish for that. But still, you think upholding the Second Amendment to the US Constitution matters more than most of gun control legislation? Huh. It sounds like I do a complete 180 on this political topic in the future, according to you. I mean, what else? What, am I going to end up being like a libertarian by the time I'm 30 or something? That, I can't imagine. Vegan? That's amazing! And for 3+ years? Holy crap, I mean, I'm here thinking how hard it would be for me to even consider being vegetarian, but you're vegan? What suddenly allowed you to do that? I mean, how do you manage it? What did my parents think, actually? And how much weight did you lose? I mean, if I lose any more weight right now, I mean, I'm already dangerously underweight as it is, you know? Social work? What's that? And New York, huh? I end up in New York City? That sounds like a crazy fantasy. I mean, I applied to 5 different colleges saying I want history to be my major. So I don't really understand how I'll end up majoring in this thing you call social work. I don't know what that is, and how I end up majoring it, that's really weird. That's my bachelor's degree, you're saying? That doesn't really seem plausible to me. How is it though? I mean, do you like it more than history? And what kind of jobs can you get with that degree? Wait, come again? Tell me again, how much do cigarettes cost in New York? That's ridiculous. Okay, yeah, so it makes sense why you ended up quitting. I mean, I have to ask though, how hard was it to quit? You didn't end up like regressing later on and picking back up smoking? Like, that's crazy. You no longer go to church? You no longer pray? Atheism? What? How does this happen? Are you sure you and I are the same person? I mean, I pray to God at least 3 times a day. I do my daily devotionals with the Bible. I blog about my Christian faith. And I mean, I frequently argue against evolutionists, you know, or those people on the internet, using my logic and evidence of God, of course. The only songs I know how to play on the guitar are Christian praise songs. So how is it possible for someone like me to end up an atheist like you? My career path, your career path, was to become a missionary and then a pastor. What happened? Man, I'm going to have to pray for you. Actually, I'm going to have to deeply pray for myself. How come you don't play the violin that much anymore? You don't think I'll be really good at it? Look, I know how to do vibratos now. It was really hard to learn after having broken my right arm, you know, but I can do it properly now, and it sounds really good. I mean, how good do I become with the violin? Do I at least play until I go to college? Metal Gear Solid 4? 4? There are sequels to Metal Gear Solid? Wow, that's awesome. Are the sequels really great? As great as Metal Gear Solid? And will they be available to play on the PC? I don't own any console like the PlayStation or the Dreamcast, so it would be best for me to if those sequels were playable on PC as well. And, you know, this novel I wrote, you know, this 200-page novel I wrote because I was so inspired by Metal Gear Solid, what happens with it? Should I try to publish it? Do you think that's doable?
Wow, 영어 진짜 잘한다. 이해를 못하겠어. 언제 내가 영어를 그렇게 잘할 수 있어? 나 이제 ABC 할 줄 안다? 참 이상해, 왜 영어는 이런 글자를 쓰는지. 그리고 이해가 안 되는 게 미국 사람들은 왜 이렇게 무섭게 생겼어? 난 한국으로 돌아가고 싶어. 어떻게 엄마 아빠를 설득해줘? 응?
It's been quite a journey for sure. Day by day, I feel the same as I had ever been. I don't feel like I've changed much, but then I look back to my past, at how I used to dress, the things I used to believe in, the life goals I had, all those things. There's no denying that the younger Burgess of me would look at who I am now and be filled with millions of questions. It's sometimes hard to believe that those younger versions of me and I are the same person. Is it inevitable that I turned out this way? I don't know. But it fascinates me as I chronicle my journey in this manner. I'd like to give my answers to those younger versions of me, but I know as time passes, I continue to evolve and change. 5 years from now, I will have different answers. And 10 years from now, I will have even more different answers. People don't change easily. But then again, in this journey of life, we might not realize it, but we are changing and growing with each passing moment. That's at least been the case for me.